Hello for Monday, May 23rd. This is the last full week of trading this month. And be a holiday next Monday, so that is the 30th. The market will be closed and be open again on the 31st. That will be the last day. Anyway, there'll be no market charts in this video because of the newsletter, so please consult it with its 60-some-odd charts, and hopefully some of those are helpful. In the background, we are listening to Hearts of Space. The link, of course, is just heartsofspace.com in the newsletter. Today's transmission is named Timescapes, Timeless, Deep Drifting, Ambient Atmospheres. Anyway, let's get to the watch list. They're all longs. Maybe they should be shorts, but you know, lately when the market looks really weak and there's a lot of stocks that look good, and then they go down for a day and then they pop right back. So we may add some, but right now they're all longs. And remember, taking some profits a little earlier than normal, we have quite a few that break out and then just pull back. Now some continue to go. We had some of those in the newsletter as well. They just keep on moving, and of course some past ones are, you know, after they settle down, they're moving up as well. But it never hurts to take some profits, some of them partial, as they come. But ARNA, you know, another biotech, this group has been hot, and it had good volume there on Friday. If it moves over that 140, then we've got the 150 area of resistance to top line here. But between that distance, that might be a trade, and then, of course, above that as well. But 140 might be the trigger point. When that begins, hopefully it doesn't do it right away at the first thing, because, you know, it's tough to play if they gap over on a low-priced stock. But watch it for a pullback, might be possible as well. In fact, some of the pullback trades have been really good, like Discovery Labs, DSCO, that pulled back and then ran again about 25-30 cents, and then it's pulled back again, but we'll wait for it now to reset up. LVLT over about $2.04. You can see it tried to break out. Actually, it broke above the 201. It broke above this lower line. So above this 196, 197, see how you like it. It's got an increase in volume lately. It looks like it wants to break up higher. If you like the lower priced ones, this one might be one that gives us a decent percentage move as well. SONS over $3.09. Now, the problem with this chart, it would be a great chart if the long red candle were further back, like say in March particularly. Right now, whether it's going to be able to break above or get above that 200-day at 313 is in question, because it hasn't had long enough time to congest whatever the problem was that made it drop. But still, it could bounce up and then over that 313, at least go up maybe, let's say, to the 50-day or even to the top line. But halfway between might be a trade. So watch that. Put that on your list. SONS over about $3.09. And, of course, with any of these, we want good volume. VELT looks interesting over 1918 or 1932. You see, both of those are wicks. So close basically at this 19 level with some resistance. Then we have the 1918 there and the 1932 next to that as well. You can't see the volumes distorted down here because of that huge day back in January. But you can see that green bar down at the bottom on Friday was increased volume, and that is a good sign for things to come. MSI, if it can move over 47.50 to 47.64, that was the high in April, you can see. And it's kind of like a little cup and then a handle coming over. Now, the problem was it was looking pretty good and it backed off on Friday. But the volume is still quite a bit under its normal average volume. So let it play around in here a while. Set it for your alerts. Maybe put an alert above the high of the day, like say 47.20, 47.25, something like that. And then if it's moving with good volume, watch that 47.50 for a possible entry there. GLBC is next up, and that one, when we can get to it, if it gets back over that $30.15, I think that might be a good move. You can see that's where it was, but it did get as high as $30.75. But I think that $30.15 would be the trade on it, particularly if it happened after, let's say, after the market's been already open a half hour or an hour. At the very beginning, it's going to be, once again, a rough call, unless the market has suddenly switched direction. I mean, when this opens on Monday, or when it, if this happens on Tuesday. Anyway, GLBC, Global Crossing, you remember one time they were hot as well. And a DNP, over about $10. This looks quite nice. I had increasing volume on the downside recently, not on the upside, but it has recovered from that. When it did fall, it fell down to the 20-day, and it bounced from there. And quite often, those have shown their strength by bouncing there, going sideways a bit, and then broke above. So let's look for this one over about $10. Anyway, that's what we have to start off the week on this Monday. So I hope you have a great day trading. We'll be sending out what we hope are useful tweets with charts and videos each day. So please pay attention to those. Otherwise, we'll be back again tomorrow with some new editions of video watch list for you. Thanks a lot. Bye-bye.